Well, these are not the earthworms that are in the soil. They are deep burrowing, the soil worms. These are surface worms. They are for home composting. They are called the red wrigglers. And I don't know much about the science, I'm sorry. But I know practically what I can do. These are surface worms and they are used in home composting mostly. What the worm does not like is too much of heat, dry conditions and very acidic soil. They don't do very well. So it's up to us to make sure that our worm bin does not get overwhelmed by all these. You know, by too much heat. When you put a lot of your kitchen waste, there is a lot of heat that generates, and that can overwhelm the worms and they may try to get out of it. So the environment in the bin is extremely important. Second, you shouldn't put too much of acidic things like orange peels, lemon peels, too much of them. Again, the entire worm bin becomes acidic and they don't do very well. Third, you should never let the worm bin dry out, because they breathe through their skin. You all know, you're not zoology students. They breathe through the skin, and if there is no moisture, again, they'll either try to get out looking for moisture or they just perish. So these are the three things that you need to take care. So let's build a worm bin. I'll actually show you how to build a worm bin. This is just a demo box. Make sure the box is not transparent because they don't like light. They like dark corners, not too much of water should be there. It shouldn't be soggy also. And make sure there are holes on the top. Whatever lid you're using, holes, or you have a gunny, gunny sack, cut it and make that as a cover for the worm bin. Make sure that you don't get rats getting inside. You have to secure it. They are helpless creatures. They can't take care of themselves. So you need to take care of them. That's extremely important. So the first thing that you need to do is you have to create a bedding material. Okay, the bedding is the bottom part of what you put in a worm bin. That is all carbon material, which is cool for them, and they always dive into it. So they come up to eat and poop. What are we looking? Why are we doing vermicompost? So that the castings, after they eat and what they poop, is the castings, and that's something that we are looking for our plants, because that's highly, it's so perfect for plants to grow well and do give us a lot of fruits and vegetables. So it's important for us to add vermicompost or the castings to our soil mixture. I am an urban farmer. I've never grown anything on the ground. I grow in my containers. So vermicomposting is a part of the container soil, and I keep adding vermicompost when every now and then so that the plants grow, I get better yield and all that. So what are the things that go as a bedding material? As I told you, it's all carbon material. So I have few things kept ready here. I'll just show you what I will put. So one of the things is dry leaves. I had soaked these dry leaves in in water, and I have kept them. So the first part, I'll put lot of moist dry leaves. See, they are so black and they are almost actually starting to break down. This is a preparation that you do well in advance so that you have enough dry leaves that you keep. And you can see they're already actually I put some cow dung in this, so they're already there'll be plenty of microorganisms here, so there's the breakdown has already started. So I put some dry leaves, then I have soaked some cow dung. Okay, the next step is dry cow dung. It should not be fresh. Fresh cow dung is highly nitrogenous, and also it is, there's a lot of heat in the fresh. So dry one, you soak it in water. Soak the dry cow dung in water. Squeeze out the excess moisture. Squeeze out the excess moisture, and then add the dry cow dung. Right? So you're going to squeeze the excess moisture. Don't make it too, watery. Squeeze out the excess moisture and add the dry cow dung. Then another thing that worms love to have is some kind of coir. So I have soaked coconut coir. Again, I completely squeeze it out and then add the coir. So this is like a nice bedding material for them, to actually relax, stay and be happy. You're giving your worm something that they can be happy. So this is one more thing, and also a little bit of cardboard. So I use some cardboard. They love cardboard, especially the corrugated cardboard. In fact, they go and they lay their eggs, you know, here. So I just put small pieces of cardboard again, squeezing out the excess water, and then add the cardboard. So this becomes your bedding material. So you see, almost half of it, I mean, it will go down. I've just layered it like this. It will go down. So this becomes the bedding material, right? And then you can see, leave this for some time, till the dry leaves are already breaking down. There's some buildup of some microorganisms there. And then next is you start putting a little bit of your kitchen waste. Before you introduce the earthworms or buy the earthworms, make sure that this, when they get in, they have enough food to eat. They cannot bite on your, food when you put fresh food. They can suck on this. They don't have teeth. But if this has already broken down, the first batch, it'll be great. So what you do is you take one batch of your food waste, one handful, and bury it under and close it. So you have buried it. See, you can see it there. It's buried. So you bury it and close it and leave it for a week. Let that start to break down. So now your bedding and your bin is ready for welcoming your worms into it. Because these earthworms are a little sensitive. They'll have transfer shock. As soon as they come, if you have put too much of vegetable peels and fruit peels, the heat could overwhelm them and they'll start crawling out. So if you, after a week, this is ready for them to, be happy, eat the food. There'll be a lot of microbes. So they start eating the microbes first, and then whatever broken down food they'll start eating. And then now you introduce these champions of the planet. To me, and also I forgot to tell that eggshells are great because they need, I made a powder of the eggshells, eggshell powder. So I also add the eggshell powder. Make sure you wash the eggs well. You don't want any, infection. So you wash the eggs well, and just the shells, you crush them and you powder them, and then you put them. When they are eating, they need something that is rough, So they swallow this also, or a little bit of soil. You can put a little bit of soil also along with the eggshells. Then you introduce these guys. These are the, can you see the, so they are either bought or, you can see them, Chandan? Chandan, you can see them?